स्टूडेंट सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस और रिवाइज अवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 5 कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम. वी विल डिस्कस समथिंग सम मेजर पॉइंट्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. सो द इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स आर फॉसिल्स दैट इज आर रिमेन्स ऑफ दैट प्लांट एंड लेयर ट्रैप बिटवीन द लेयर्स ऑफ रॉक. एंड सेकेंड इज पेट्रोलियम इज अ क्रूड ऑयल. Okay, so these are natural resources which are trapped between layers of rock, and the terms resources, the substances which we get from the nature to fulfill our needs, that are called resources. Okay, and natural resources comes like coal and petroleum. These are natural resources. Okay. So, first, fossils are the dead remains of plants and animals. When plants and animals die millions of years ago, then they converted into a fossils. Petroleum is also known as crude oil. Petroleum, it is a natural resource, and it is also known as crude oil, and it is also known as black gold. Why black gold? Because when we extracted from a rock, that is black in color. And why gold? Because because of its valuable property. Okay. Now, natural gas is another natural resources. It is a gaseous natural fossil fuel consisting mainly of methane. So when we extract petroleum from the rocks, then natural gas is also present with petroleum. So natural gas is a gaseous fossil fuel consisting mainly of methane. Methane is a gas, main constituent of natural gas. Then we can reduce pollution by using renewable sources of energies. You all know that coal and petroleum, when we burn them, they are fuel. When we burn them, they produce the harmful gases in our environment, which pollute the atmosphere. So instead of using those resources, we should switch to some renewable resources of energy. So under renewable resources come wind energy, solar energy, water energy. Okay, now some of the important internal question which you have to remember from this chapter. First is carbonization. So carbonization is the process of conversion of wood into coal in the absence of air. Okay, so when plants die, they buried inside the earth, and as they both go deeper inside the earth, the bacteria start acting on them, and they act in the absence of air. So the wood is converted into coal by whom? By bacteria in the absence of air, and this process is known as carbonization. Okay, another internal question which is very important, that is, why is anthracite considered to be best variety of coal? So in this chapter, we have studied the four varieties of coal, and the four varieties were peat, lignite, bituminous, and at last anthracite. So out of these four varieties, anthracite is best because this variety of coal is found deeper in the earth. The first category come at the top. It is present at the top. Then it's below it comes lignite. Below it comes bituminous. And the last one is anthracite. So why it is the best? Because more deeper the variety of coal is present, the less moisture is present in the coal. So anthracite is found at a greater depth. It has a maximum carbon content and a very high calorific value. It produces more energy as compared to the previous variety of coal. Another question which is very important, that what happened when coal tar is distilled? Now what is coal tar? You all know a coal is a natural resource. So when we heat coal in the absence of air, okay, in the absence of air, we get components of coal which are coal tar, coke and coal gas. Okay, so now in the question, what is asked? What happened when coal tar is distilled? So when we are taking these components of coal tar, what will happen if we distill it? Distillation of coal tar yields several fraction. When we distill it, it produces many components like benzene, toluene, xylene, naphthalene, anthracene. Though these are fractions are known as coal tar crudes. Okay, I hope you all understood. Now the next question is, what do you mean by the term refining? You all know what is crude oil, what is petroleum. So we cannot use it directly. So we need to separate their components first. So that process of separating crude components is known as refining. So the process of separating crude oil into different useful components by fractional distillation. By this process, we separate the components of petroleum. And what are the components of petroleum? Like we get components like petrol, diesel, kerosene, hai na? So, now the next question is, which you have to prepare, that is greenhouse effect. Warming up of the atmosphere due to the trapping of infrared radiation by carbon dioxide gas is known as greenhouse effect. And the second topic is global warming, that is increasing the temperature of earth due to increase in the concentration of CO2, carbon dioxide, in air. Now I guess students get confused between greenhouse effect and global warming. So they mix the answer of these two terms. So what is the difference between greenhouse effect and global warming is, see, this is our earth. And this is sun, and we know that harmful radiation come from the sun, ultraviolet radiation, and we know that around the earth we have a atmosphere, layer of atmosphere. This atmosphere contains carbon dioxide gas also, okay. So when these radiation come from the sun, our earth's surface reflect this radiation, but these carbon dioxide gas molecule, they do not let these radiation escape our atmosphere. They trap this radiation. So this trapping of radiation is known as greenhouse effect. So what is greenhouse effect? Trapping of these harmful radiation by the carbon dioxide gas. Now, as it is trapping the radiation, so hence the temperature of an earth will automatically increase. So that increasing in the temperature of earth is known as global warming. Okay. Now I hope you all understood between the difference between the global warming and greenhouse effect. So trapping of radiation, greenhouse effect, increase in temperature, global warming. Okay. Another question. Why are fossil fuel considered to be an exhaustible natural resources? So natural resources like fossil fuels are exhaustible, which means we will make use of, it continuously, but at some point it get distinct from the nature. So natural resources like fossil fuel are present in a fixed or limited amount, and they can be exhausted by human activities as natural processes cannot renew them fast. Okay. It takes millions of years to form the coal and petroleum or natural gas. Now, are fossil fuel are also a type of natural resource? What do you think? The fossil fuel also a type of natural resources? So yes, they are natural resources because they are the remain of plants and animals, and they are present in the nature. So they are natural resources as they form from the remain of plant and animal which get buried for millions of years. Okay. So why is natural gas is preferred over all other fuels? What is the advantages of using natural gas? देखिए, because it is less polluting, it is a clean fuel, and it is also can be transported through the pipelines and stored under high pressure. Therefore, natural gas is preferred over all other gases. Okay, over all other fossil fuels. We can compress CNG, so that is why it is also known as CNG, which we use nowadays in our vehicle also. Okay, now the next question is, what are oil well? Well, from which extract oil? The well from where we extract oil. So petroleum is obtained by drilling holes into the earth crust, and they are known as oil wells. And how they are constructed? They are constructed for transporting oil through pipes to oil refineries for further processing. We transport that crude oil to the refineries where the process of refining is done, and we get different component, different fraction of petroleum. And what are the different fraction? So you have, which is very important, what are the different fractions of obtained from the petroleum? And what are they, where they are used? First is petroleum gas, or you can say LPG, liquefied petroleum gas. And where we use it? We use it homes, fuel for home and industry. You use this gas. Now is petrol. Petrol, you all know, for fuel for automobiles. Then kerosene. Kerosene used as a fuel for jet aircraft. And the next is diesel oil, which is we use for heavy motor vehicle. ठीक है? Now next question is, what are the product that we obtain from the destructive distillation of coal? As I told you, when we heat coal in the absence of air, that process is known as destructive distillation. And what products do we obtain? We get three products, which are coke, it is used in the extraction of iron. That is not your soft drink, cold drink which you always drink. No, it is. So from coke, the extraction of iron take place. So then next is coal tar. They form the starting material for the synthesis of dyes and drugs. Okay. Now the third one is coal gas. So it is used as a source for fuel for domestic cooking. Okay, it is used for as a fuel for domestic cookings. And the last and the most important question, how are natural resources classified? And I hope you all know the answer of this question, that a natural resources can be broadly classified into two types on the basis of the availability in the nature, and that is inexhaustible. And the second is exhaustible natural resources. Okay, so what are inexhaustible resources? These are those resources which continually renewed by nature and are not likely to be exhausted. Example, air and sunlight, etc. If they are present in limited amount, they can be renewed by themselves only in nature. But the exhaustible natural resources are those resources which are present in a fixed amount in our nature and cannot be exhausted, and can be exhausted by human activities. Example, coal, petroleum, etc. Okay, I hope you all understood this chapter very well. Still, if you have any doubt, you can ask me in your WhatsApp group. Okay, thank you, class.